Christ. At the count of three, if you can run, Oya run. If you can jump, Oya jump. One, two, three. Someone on me gonna call it for ya. Ni achengi nile, ni achengi nicheze. Yesu mwana mungu, amejibu maombi yangu. Yesu mwana mungu amejibu maombi yangu sema
niache nini imbe niache nini cheze Yesu mwana mungu amejibu maombi yangu
amenitoa chini ameniweka juu Yesu mwana mungu amejibu maombi yangu sema
niache nini imbe
niache
nini
cheze
Yesu mwana mungu amejibu maombi yangu
Leo Bwana Yesu amekupa
Yesu mwanangu amejibu maombi yangu. Niache nime, niache nime.
Against you that shall ever prosper. No weapon fashioned against your children. No weapon fashioned against your business. No weapon fashioned against you is going to prosper. I just need you to raise up your two hands like this, and we start clapping. Higher, turn it. Silaha yeyote iliyotumwa kinyume
haitafaulu.
One more time, hakuna silaha yeyote
something that is too hard for God. I've come to tell you something different. There's nothing He cannot do. What is impossible with you is possible with God. There is no situation He cannot turn around. There is no name that is above His name. There is no name that should be exalted above His holy name. There is no name that should be raised higher if it is not for His name. And so speak to that situation this morning. Speak to whatever is going through in your life that is trying to magnify itself, that is trying to magnify itself. It's trying to take the glory of the King of Kings. It's trying to take the glory of the Master of the Universe. I mean, He's the Alpha and the Omega. He knew you before you were born. He knew you before you were created. So who lies to you that there's nothing that catches in my surprise? There's nothing that catches in my surprise. Speak to that mountain today. I assure you, as you walk out of this door this morning, you're gonna find the answer. I am not speaking, I am standing in the midst of its faithfulness. I am standing in the midst of its faithfulness because I speak to a mountain that was trying to exalt itself. I told it, move, because I serve a God. I serve a living God, and that is who we are here to glorify and to adore. Let me hear you say, kwa nini jambo lipi?
Kwa nini jambo?
Ni jambo lipi hilo?
Lipi.
Ambalo yeye asilo liweza.
Yeye asilo liweza.
One more time with your hands lifted high. Kwa nini jambo lipi hilo?
Kwa nini jambo?
Ambalo Bwana Yesu hawezi. Ni tatizo gani linalokusumbua roho ambalo Bwana Yesu hawezi? Ni shida gani? But I have not found a man who is worthy.
He's gonna give it to you. Imasika, if you can speak in tongues, go ahead. Imasika,
Almighty Father, because you are with us and you go before us, Lord.
You keep,
oh, it's a promise you keep. You will never leave us or forsake us, Lord. So, Lord, we stand confident and bold, Almighty Father, in the midst of every single thing that we go through, Almighty Father, because we are not alone, Almighty Father. Nothing separates us from your love. Your love resides in us, and your love goes before us. Your love goes behind us to protect us. Your love is with us. Thank you, Lord, that that makes us more than conquerors. Lord, I thank you that we are more than conquerors, because we know the one who goes before us. The one who goes before us makes all the crooked places straight. The one who goes before us makes all the mountains plain. Oh, you're not alone. Oh, you're not alone. Yeah. Oh, I'm never alone. God is with me. God is with me. Yeah. Oh, aren't you glad that God is with you? God is with you. God is with you. Oh, my sister, don't you fret. Oh, my sister, don't you worry. Oh, don't you worry. Cause God is with you. God goes before you. God goes behind you. Oh, you are blessed. You are blessed beyond measure. Just open your eyes and see him. Just open your eyes and see him. Just open your eyes and see him. Cause he's with you. He never breaks. Our God, sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, how great is our God. We'll see.
Our King's Daughters meeting. It's good to see you, that we are together again at this meeting in the presence of God. We want to thank God that God is always with us. God is always with us. Lift up your hands. We are together again in the presence of God. We are not alone. We are together again in the presence of God. It's good that we are together again. It's good that we are together again. It's good that we are together again. Let's appreciate God that we are together again. That we are together again in the presence of God. It's good that we are together again. It's good that we are together again. It's good that we are together again in the presence of God. It's good. We are together again. Something good is going to happen in our lives. Something good is going to happen in our lives. Clap your hands to the Lord. Say amen. Something good is going to happen in our lives. You believe that? Something good is going. We are in the presence of God. Something good is going to happen in our lives. Clap your hands to the Lord. Clap your hands to the Lord. Clap your hands to the Lord. Let's continue to praise Him. Father, we praise You. We give You glory. We continue to trust You. We know that Your promises are yea and amen. Father, we give You praise. We give You all the glory. We give You all the glory. Ladies, let's just continue to praise God. Clap your hands to Him. Let's give Him all the praise. Let's give Him all the praise. Let's give Him all the praise. Something good is going to happen in our lives. We are not alone. He's not going to leave us. He's not going to leave us. Ladies, God is not going to leave us. That is why we always come here, to be in the presence of God. Ladies, you may be seated. It's good that we are together again. It's good that we are together again in the presence of God. It's really good that we are together again at our King's Daughters meeting in the presence of God. Pastor Eunice Muigai is here. It's good to see you. It's used to see you that you have come to our King's Daughters meeting in the presence of God. Your husband died, and I pray that God will give you grace and peace to stand in this difficult time. Nancy Cole, come and pray. Come, let's pray for Pastor Eunice Muigai, my daughter, my King's daughter.
Let's all rise up and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank You. We want to glorify Your name, O God. We want to lift You up because You are God all by Yourself. And there is nothing that is impossible with You, King of Glory. This morning we come into Your presence because You tell us when we call on Your name, You hear us, Jehovah Father. And this morning we want to lift Pastor Eunice in Your presence, my God, thanking You, Father, for how far You have preserved her, how far, God, You have strengthened her, how far, God, You have uplifted her, even coming before Your presence today, my Father. I want to decree and declare that You are her strength this morning. I want to decree and declare You are her strong tower this morning. I want to decree and declare You are her stronghold this morning, Jehovah God. And so, mighty Father, we pray that You'll continue to lift her, O God, that You'll continue to strengthen her, O God, that You'll continue to uphold her, my Father. You are the God that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above what we could ask or imagine. And this morning we want to lay her in Your presence, O God, that Your presence shall surround her, O God. My Father, as the mountain surrounds Jerusalem, O God, so Thou surrounds her with favor, King of Glory. So Thou surrounds her with Yourself, my Father. This morning I pray, O King of Glory, that You shall protect her, my God. We cover her with the blood of Jesus Christ. We cover her children with the blood of Jesus Christ. We cover, my Father, H.O.G. Ruaka, with the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, we decree and declare that no weapon of the enemy formed against her shall stand, my God. I pray that, Jehovah God, You shall uphold Your church, my Father, that You shall continue to build Your church, King of Glory, that no gates of hell shall prevail against it, my God. Continue to lead her, continue to guide her, continue to allow Your presence to even saturate her, my God. May she never feel alone, Jehovah God. May You overwhelm her with Your presence, that, Lord, even as she rises up in the morning, as she does her work through the day, my God, in the morning, in the noontime, in the night, oh God, every moment, every second, every minute, oh God, I pray that Your presence will overwhelm her. May she never feel she's alone, my God, even for the work that is ahead of her. How I pray that, Lord, You shall pour Your wisdom, that, Lord, You shall pour Your insight, that, Lord, You shall pour Your understanding upon her, my Father, that whatever she needs to do, my God, You shall show her, my Father, that she will hear Your voice saying, this is the way, walk ye in it, Jehovah God. May Your Spirit guide her steps, my God. May the Spirit of God order her steps, my Father, even for the children, my God, for the daughters, my Father, we surround them all with the blood of Jesus. I pray that, God, in their going in their coming out, Jehovah, that, Lord, You shall preserve them, my Father, that You shall keep them from harm, oh God, that no works of the enemy shall prevail against them, Jehovah. I pray, O King of glory, in these seasons of her life, O God, and in the years ahead, Jehovah God, that they will testify of the goodness of God. They will testify of the faithfulness of God. They will testify of the mercies of God. They will testify of the protection of God. Because, Father, you shall be with them. They shall experience you, O God, like never before. You shall lift them up, O God. They shall never lack anything they need for life and godliness. You shall be their provider, that nothing, my God, I decree and declare, nothing, they will never lack anything, because Lord, you shall be their provider. And so, Father, we commend them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to you. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
And God will continue to comfort you and your children. Pastor Eunice, may you have a good life. May you have a good life. You may be seated, ladies. Thank you for praying for Pastor Eunice Muigai. Thank you that we have done that together. Ladies, it's good that we are actually together again. Let us worship God with our giving. Let us worship God with our giving, our tithes and offerings. Let's worship God with our tithes and offerings. Okay, let's worship him with our giving. And God says that he'll open the windows of heaven and pour down a blessing. Our blessings will come down. Our blessings are going to come down. Let us worship God with our giving. Let us read the book of Malachi chapter 3 verse 10. Malachi chapter 3 verse 10, let us read. The Bible says, bring all the tithes into storehouse, that there may be food in my house, and try me now in this, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessing that there will not be room enough to receive it. Ladies, giving is worship. Giving is worship. Let us worship God with our giving. God promised to open the windows and pour out a blessing. Let us begin to worship God with our giving. Let us begin to worship God with our giving, ladies. And if you have cash, if you have some cash, and you want to worship God with your giving, you can come forward here to the altar to bring your giving to worship God. You can also use the till number or the M-Pesa number. As you give, you'll receive the blessings from God. As you give, may you receive the blessings from God. As you give, may you receive the blessings from God. As we worship God with our giving, may you receive the blessings from God. Let's begin to worship God with our giving. If you have some cash, you can come forward and bring your giving here at the altar. Thank you.
wewe huainua na wanyonge siku zote. Watu epusha na adari kila siku usifiwe.
Blessings, receive your blessings in Jesus' name. Receive your blessings in Jesus' name. Our speaker is Pastor Mercy Masharia of Harvest Family Church at Rongai. Let us celebrate her as we welcome her to come and speak the word of God, the power of submission. Welcome. Welcome, Pastor Mercy Masharia. She's a very good daughter. She always comes to our King's Daughters meeting.
Wow. Let's appreciate our mom. Come on, put your hands together for mom. Appreciate her. Come on, appreciate her very well. Amen. Are we happy to be here? Are we really excited? I would like, if you can see a seat in front of you, and it's not the front seat, just occupy it so that we are not so far behind. Amen. Are we glad that we are in the presence of the Lord? Are we glad? Why don't you appreciate Jesus in the house? In the name of Jesus. Amen. I would like you to open your mouth and tell God, thank you for bringing you to this place. Just open your heart and tell him, Lord, I came and I'm open to receive from you. I would like you to speak to me. Come on, just tell the Lord something. Open your mouth. We are in the presence of the Lord. I believe that the Lord has something for you today. There's something he wants you to learn. There's something he would want you to receive today. Just open your mouth and tell him, I receive from you even before I hear the word. May you speak to us, oh God. In Jesus' name. And somebody said, are you sure you are ready to receive today? Amen. I would like to just take this opportunity to appreciate my mother, Reverend Ronica Moreithi. Ngojeni kwanza. You are very fast. So I want to appreciate her for many reasons, and one of them, the major one being that she raised me to be the person I am today. I remember when I came to House of Grace. You know, I came here, I got to meet her before I was married. She's the one who taught me how to be a wife. She took me through counseling, taught me how. One of the things she told me that I can remember is that I need to be organized in my house. She told me, you cannot be buying onions when your husband, on your way home from the service, in the evening service, that's when you're buying mboga and onions to go cook for your husband. You should have cooked earlier. Are we together? She told me you have to learn to organize yourself and many other things. I would like us to appreciate my mother very well. Come on, appreciate her. She has mentored many of us. She's mentoring us even right now. Come on, appreciate her very well. Do we love our mother? Can we tell her we love you, mom? Amen. We love you, we appreciate you, and we honor God for you. And I would like us to appreciate our father, Bishop David Moreithi. Do we love our father in the house? Do we love him? Do we honor him? Let's appreciate the angel of this house, Bishop David Moraithi. He's our father. We love him dearly and we thank God for his life. We are because he is. Are we together? One more time with that revelation. Appreciate him very well in Jesus' name. Why don't you appreciate yourselves for coming as well? Amen. You may have your seats in the presence of the Lord. I thank God for all my sisters in the house. Pastor Eunice, it's good to see you. Pastor Cool's wife, Pastor Nancy. Yes, it's good to see you. Angel, good to see you always. You always look angelic. Amen. I also came with some beautiful ladies from Rongai Harvest Family Church. Women of Excellence, please just raise your hands and wave. Come on, let's appreciate them very well. Thank you so much for accompanying me. And we are here to be blessed together in Jesus' name. Amen. I also bring you greetings from my husband, Pastor Jimmy Masharia. Come on, appreciate him. And do you receive the greetings? Amen. He told me, preach powerfully. I said, I receive the blessing and I will preach by the grace of God. Amen. Do you receive his greetings? Amen. So today we are learning on the power of submission. Just a disclaimer, I am a bit under the weather. The enemy tried to attack me yesterday with a cold. But I told him, I have to preach. That's why I'm here. To just show him he has done nothing in Jesus' name. So if you can receive better, we shall have a powerful service in Jesus' name. Amen. Somebody say, the power of submission. Wow. Now, many of us, when we hear the word submission, hey, ask your neighbor, what do you do when you hear submit? Hey, we are always ready to attack, ready to defend ourselves. Because I think to many of us, when that word makes us feel like someone wants to dominate us, someone wants to make us a doormat, different theories are out there. But I would like you to know that submission is a spiritual word. Can I hear an amen? I just want to define the word to submit, and then we shall read the scripture. Now, the Bible, not the Bible, but I looked up this word, submit. Somebody say submit. Ask your neighbor, will you submit? They may not be ready to give an answer now, but I believe at the end of the service, they will have considered their answer, isn't it? So to submit is to accept or yield to a superior force. To submit is to accept or yield to a superior force or to accept the will of another person. To submit is to accept or yield to a superior force or to accept the will of another person. Now, I would like us to know that in the order of God and in the mind of God, when he has organized and he has put in place that when we are relating with authorities, we should relate with them on the basis of submission. Somebody say, when I'm relating with an authority, ama ni vile tumevaa mask. When you have a mask, you need to add a bit of volume, okay? I say, when I'm relating with an authority, I will relate with them through submission. Beautiful. Now, let's read the Bible in the book of Romans, chapter 13, verse 1 to 7. That will be our main scripture for today. And if we can have it in New Living Translation, I'll appreciate. Amen. Romans 13, verse 1 to 7. And I would like us to read together once it's up. I don't know whether we have it already. Is it up already? I'm only seeing my face, my beautiful face. Amen. Are we in Romans 13? Okay, let me hope it's coming, probably. Yes, good. Let's read together. One, two, go. No, tell your neighbor, we are reading together. One, two, go. Everyone must submit to governing authorities, for all authority comes from God, and those in positions of authority have been placed there by God. Verse two. So anyone who rebels against rebelling against what God has instituted, and they will be done what? They will be punished. Hey, somebody say minus me. Verse 3. For the authorities do not strike fear in people who are doing right, but in those who are doing wrong. Would you like to live with fear of the authorities, or to live without fear of the authorities? Sorry. Do what is right, and they will. Wow. May you be honored by an authority in Jesus' name. Now you are warming up. Verse 4, the Bible says, for the authorities are God's servants, sent for, somebody say, for my good. Uh-huh. But if you are doing wrong, of course, you should be afraid, for they have the power to punish you. They are God's servants, sent for the very purpose of punishing those who do. Tell your neighbor, authorities can be for your good, or they can be for your punishment. The choice is all yours. Verse 5. The Bible says, so you must submit to. Is it you may submit, or you might choose what to or not? Somebody say, I must. Uh-huh. Can we read together? So you must submit to them, not only to avoid punishment, but also to keep a clear conscience. That is to mean that when you are walking in submission, you have nothing to fear. You are free of any anxiety, any fear, and all that. May that be your portion in Jesus' name. Now, verse 6, the Bible says, wow, can we take that up again? Pay your taxes too, for these same reasons. For government works need to be paid. Hey, my God. For those of you who have been fighting paying taxes, are you seeing this? Can we read together one more time? Hey, I think the government, if they go to know this scripture, let's read together. Pay your taxes too, for these same reasons, for government workers need to be paid. They are serving God in what they do. Wow, amazing. Verse 7 and the last one. Give to everyone what you owe them. Pay your taxes and government fees to those who collect them, and give respect and honor to those who are in authority. Now remember, we are talking about the power of submission. Somebody say, the power of submission. Now I would like to share with us three reasons. I have a number. I hope you are ready for me, because I want to show you why we should submit, and then how we should submit, and then we'll also look at the power of submission. It's like, you know, why should I? Then how do I do it? Then what will I get after I do it and I'll be done with you? Are you ready for me? Why do we submit? It's a question. I want to give you three reasons. Number one, by submitting to authority, we are submitting to God. Somebody say, by submitting to authority, I am submitting to God. Now, I know we are ladies here, so I could narrow down to submitting to husbands. But then I'm also aware that not all of us are married. And when we talk about submitting to authority, it does not just confine us to husbands only. You have seen, we are even talking about government authorities. So anybody that God has put in authority over your life requires, God requires you. He demands, he expects you to relate with them on the basis of submission. Can I hear an amen? That is to mean your parents, you need to submit to them. You need to submit to your husband. You need to submit to your pastor. Hey, can I hear an amen? We need to submit to our bosses. We need to submit to government authorities and any person who is in authority. May God give us grace to submit to those who are in authority. Now, the reason we are saying that by submitting to an authority, you are submitting to God, it is because the Bible says from verse 1 and 2 that those who are in authority are appointed by God. It is God who chooses. It is not man. I know we even leaders, presidents, and all that, MPs, but I would like you to know, unless God favors somebody, they can never sit on that seat. So you may have your preference on, this is the one I like, or this other one, I don't like them. But the day the Lord allows somebody to sit in the office, just settle it in your heart. That is the leader that God has appointed. Can I hear an amen? Or you can say, ouch. So somebody said, by submitting to authority, I am submitting to God. So even when you are submitting to authority from your husband, you are actually submitting to God. Now, God is so orderly and so organized. I know many of us feel like I can relate with God directly. As for me, I don't need man. Have you ever said that statement, or have you ever heard someone say that? Me, I relate with God directly. God operates in systems. There are some blessings that will never land to your address until you are aligned with some authorities in your life. Oh, I have experienced it firsthand. Praise the Lord. I am not standing here because I'm an angel. I know we have an angel in the house. But what I'm saying is, I'm not saying that I'm perfect. I have also struggled with submission before. And I realized anytime I am not flowing and I'm not submitting to the authorities over my life, things become very difficult. Are we together? Because by resisting an authority, whether they are right or wrong, whether you think they are favorable to you or they are not, you actually suffer the consequences. Somebody say, I will submit to authorities. And by that, I will be submitting to God. Now, let me give you the other reason. Are you writing these things? Amen. Why do we submit to authorities? Number two, by submitting to authority, we avoid punishment. We avoid punishment. We read in verse 2 that, so anyone who rebels against authority is rebelling against what God has instituted, and they will be punished. So every rebellion, you know, rebellion, you don't have to come before an authority and say, I don't like you. Rebellion is in the heart. And submission is in the heart. Aish, can I hear an amen? If you pretend before an authority that you are submitted to them, and you are not lying to them. By the way, every authority has an oil over their lives. They have an anointing, because it is God who put them there to represent him. So what happens is that their authority and their office begins to fight you. Are you getting scared? I have even seen, let me now narrow down to a home setting. A woman who is not submitted to her husband, even when they give instructions to house helps, they don't obey. Because you have to reap what you have sown. Yeah. It's an ouch. Just say Allah. Yeah, it happens. But if you are aligned, because the oil has to flow from God to Aaron's head, flowing all the way to the skirts, even in the house. So when a woman is not aligned to her husband, because the Lord releases a blessing through your husband, he's the priest of the home. When you are out of order, or you are trying to challenge his authority, now watch and waeleze, can I tell you? Women have a certain thing. I think it's inborn, or it's one of the fallen natures of women. The Bible says it's a curse in the Garden of Eden. Eve was told, you will always try to control your husband. Women have a thing of wanting to control. Oi. Are you in agreement? Are you aware that you have that thing? Because unless you are aware, you will not deal with it. And we do it in a subtle way. Oh my God. We don't have to raise our voices. You can even tell your husband, yes, I have heard you, my husband. But in your heart, you know, me, I will not do it. I ain't doing it. I will not do what you have said. It's an evil. And you keep wondering why you are not experiencing the fullness of God's blessing. It is because you are out of alignment with your authority. Hey, you know, for me, I don't know why, today when I was just meditating on this word, I realized my life has been very interesting. Because before I got married, I was serving in my father's ministry for 6 years. Now, have you heard, it's a father, this is a father, and also my pastor. So you have to balance the two. Now, fast forward, I get married, my husband is also my pastor. Praise the Lord. So I have to differentiate when I'm dealing with a husband and when I'm dealing with my pastor. Do you know when we are in our church, I do not address him as, when I'm talking to the congregation, your father. I say our father. Nowadays, I found myself saying, Dad. Hiya. Jehovah. I wondered, Jesus Christ. I was only praying, Lord, make me submissive. I realized I've started seeing him as a father, even to me. Not in bed. In bed, he's not my father. Praise the Lord. Can I be practical? And you know, it switches. The moment we leave ministry matters, his sweetheart and my baby and all that. But when we are addressing spiritual matters, because I realized if I continue to be a wife when everybody is receiving from him from this level, you know, you have to look. Can I say something? Oil does not go like this. Oil trickles down. And for you to receive oil, for you to receive an anointing, for you to receive a blessing from somebody in authority, you have to stoop low. Oh, yes. You have to humble yourself. You have to take a submissive position. Not physically. Physically, spiritually, and in all dimensions. Can I hear an amen in the house? Now, the challenge comes when an authority asks you to do something that you don't like doing. Or something that you actually don't think is correct. One day, can I hear somebody saying one day? Just enjoy my stories. Because if I don't give my own examples, then whatever I'm preaching may not really make a lot of sense. So it was in 2020, last year, my husband told me we had just clocked 10 years since we started having Women of Excellence. Okay? We were actually celebrating our 10th anniversary. And he told me, I would like you to not be doing your meetings every month so that you can be more effective. Do them quarterly. If you realize, Women of Excellence meetings are majorly, that's the only time I get to like preach. And are you realizing by the grace of God, I am also called? I am not a pastor because I'm married to a pastor. If you didn't know, let me just help you understand. We met in Bible school. Are we together? So the Lord called me. Can you do like this? Come and serve me. He also called my husband. When I went to Bible school, we met together. I am called, you are called, we have been called, we are studying together. But you see now, when we got married, I had to align to the vision God has given him. And you think it is as easy as I'm saying. It is a process of breaking that God takes you through. Can I hear a hallelujah? So one day he allowed me to start to do Women of Excellence. So I knew every month I'll be preaching. Praise the Lord. Then he tells me, now you'll be preaching 4 times in a week, in a month, in a year. Quarterly, it's 4 times in a year. And do you know, by the grace of God, I am telling you before God, I never felt like I want to fight for my position. I want to fight to preach every month. No, I told him, yes, sir. And I remember the day I announced in church and told ladies, the way I said it, nilipata wote wamesimama. They gave the announcement a standing ovation. Because I didn't say it like, can you imagine women? Your father. In another town called Kitengela. The day he announced in church, everybody was like, gosh. They didn't know whether to celebrate or to say yes or no. But you see, let me tell you, one thing I have come to learn, when you learn to flow with an authority, you will never go wrong. And even when you feel like probably whatever they are saying may not really align to what you are thinking, if you flow with them, you experience the blessings of God. I have now been preaching in that church for 3 Sundays, and I'm telling you, we are growing every day. I am experiencing grace. I drive to Kitengela 3 times a week, and I don't feel tired at all. Are we together? Why? Because I'm operating under grace. So by submitting to an authority, you are submitting to God, and then you avoid punishment. Most of us, we are struggling, even at your place of work, because even in the house, you are not in alignment with your authority. May God help us. Help us. Somebody say, may Jesus help me. Number 3, why do we submit to authorities? We submit to authorities, to when you by submitting to an authority, you enjoy peace, good things, and honor. You enjoy peace, good things, and honor. We read it in scripture, that verse 5, so you must submit them to them, not only to avoid punishment, but also to keep a clear conscience. So that clear conscience is peace. You know, you are like, I am in right standing with God. I am not in opposition with my leader. And you know, for me, it started even by tithing. I tithe to my husband. Praise the Lord. Wow. Munashanga. Yes, because I see him as my priest. Are we together? And I kneel down, I ask him, please, say a word before I can go to minister. And let me tell you, it really works. So if you can just embrace what I'm telling you, submit to your husband if you have one, submit to the authorities God has given you, you'll see great things happening in your life. Now, how do we submit? We have talked about why. Now we are talking about how do we submit to authority. Number one, we submit by honoring our authorities. Somebody say, I will submit by honoring my authorities. Honor, we can take a whole day learning about honor. But if you honor someone, you speak well about them. Are we together? Not only in their presence, but even in their absence. You cannot be found somewhere gossiping someone you claim to honor. Are we together? Participating or even listening. I don't know why Christians, we are so afraid of standing up for what we believe. Yeah. You cannot find someone talking about your father, talking about your leader, talking about your husband. Some women even listen when people are telling them, I saw your husband, I don't know where. What are you even talking about? Whether they saw them or not, tell them, shut up. Do you realize you are talking about my priest? Shut them up. Are we together? And most of you, you are actually ruining your marriages because you listen to too much gossip. Why have you positioned people, wanaita guanini, CIDs, whoever? Eh? Your spies. To be calling you to tell you, yeah, he's now at Java. And there's a lady seated next to, like, really? We bind Satan in Jesus' name. I somebody say, I will not operate like that. Let the Lord watch over your husband. He will do a better job. All you need to do, submit, pray for him, do your thing. You do what you are supposed to be doing. The Lord will do the rest. And you will have so much peace. But if you decide where when your utter position people to tell you, hey, I'm a pitia hapa sai, then you start calling him. I thought you told me you were going, I don't know where. Somebody has told me they have seen your car. Like, really? Huh. Somebody say we have to be delivered. Yes, so by honoring authorities, you speak well about them, you know, you address them honorably. Anybody you honor, you cannot just be addressing them like they are your peer or like they are your junior or like they are somebody who is just an ordinary person. The way you address them, the way you talk to them has to show honor. When you are in their presence, can I hear an amen in the house? Yeah, I love mom, I love my bishop, my father, but... let me tell you, up to today, from the day I came to House of Grace, when I see Paps, I start sweating. Not because I fear him. I think it's honor. I love him so much. But when I see him, I'm like, oh my God. I think his voice just, enough. I shake. But you see, I have to maintain a smile. Yes, Paps. And I'm thinking, Kai, boy, what do I even say? And I don't want that thing to end. The day it finishes, I will have become familiar with him. And that's the day I would stop receiving a blessing from him. And by maintaining that, any word he speaks, it has an effect over my life. Yeah. By the way, he came and spoke, he poured oil on me, releasing me to go to Kitengela. And he declared powerful things and they are already happening. Why? Because I honor him. Are we together? I honor my husband. Yeah. I honor authorities. Even my own father, I honor him. Wacha niwaeleze. Kwanza, honoring people that you know very well. It's not easy. Your husband, you know too well. Both those of you who are married. Amma, you don't know your husband. You know the good, the bad, and you are the ones who said, me, I don't have any. But you know them, you see them at their weakest point. So telling yourself that now I'm seeing him and I'm only seeing the anointing, it takes a higher level of grace. May you receive that grace in Jesus' name. That you will not forget who your authority is simply because you have seen them at a low moment. Are we together? Somebody say, I will honor my authorities. So how do we honor them? I say by how do we submit? By honoring them. Showing honor is a sign of submission. You cannot say that you submit to somebody that you don't honor. By there to submit to someone, you have to see them as great people. Don't ever allow anybody to tamper with your perception of your authority. Always see them like my God. You know the way as children look at their parents like they know everything. Mama, you don't know that's the case. Children could think that their parents have everything. They can buy them anything. They can beat anybody who tries to tamper with them. They can solve all manner of problems. That is the kind of a mind you should have about an authority. Anybody who tries to tell you something different, you have to see them as an enemy. Because they cannot bless you. But your authority can either bless you or curse you. Eish! Somebody said, the one who holds my blessing, I will not allow anybody to tamper with my perception about them. Your perception has to be honor. Somebody say, I will honor. Yeah. Another way of honoring is even giving gifts. You cannot say you honor someone, but even on their special days, like now, mom, on her, you don't even know her birthday, praise the Lord, and you claim, I honor mama, I honor my mother. Yeah. By the grace of God, every Mother's Day and every of her birthdays, by the grace of God, I honor her. Are we together? Yes. I have realized that, especially Mother's Day, I have several mothers. I have my biological mother. I also have a stepmother. I have mom here, my spiritual mother. I have my mother in love. And I think I have like five mothers. And do you know, by the grace of God, I package a gift for all of them. Now, Mimi, after I have done it, because the Lord reciprocates, there are daughters that will never forget it is Mother's Day. So you realize whatever I gave as a gift, the Lord brings it back, pressed down, shaken together, and because when you show honor, you will also be honored. Ask your neighbor, have you been honored by anybody so far? Probably it's because you don't honor anyone. Eish, somebody say we are changing. How do we submit to authorities? We say number one, by honoring them. Number two, we submit to authorities by obeying them. By obeying. Honor and obedience is different. Now, obeying, I had mentioned something earlier as I was sharing my stories that submitting when you are being asked to do something you don't like or you think is a bit uncomfortable is not easy. But we have a perfect example of someone who obeyed. He submitted and obeyed unto death, and that is Jesus. Can I hear an amen? Philippians 2 verse 5 to 8. The Bible says Philippians 2, 5 to 8. Are you learning something? Are you receiving some powerful knowledge? Philippians 2, 5 to 8. The Bible says you must have the same attitude that Jesus had. If we can have the scripture. Though he was God, verse 6. Wow. Though he was God, he did not think, can we read together? Though he was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to. That is to mean he was ready to let it go. Uh-huh. Instead, he gave up his divine privileges. He took the humble position of a slave and was born as a human being when he appeared in human form. And what happened to him? Verse 8. He humbled himself in obedience to God and died a criminal's death on a cross. So submission sometimes will require you to obey even when it is not convenient. For somebody who is in authority, when they ask you to do something, you see, like today, I would say I'm unwell. But because mom asked me, come and preach, there's no way I would have picked my phone and tell her, hey, hello, mom, so casually, like, I'm not feeling well, please find someone else. That is dishonor. Unless I don't have a voice. And even if, I'll come here so that it will even be evident. Hello. And God, because God knows my heart desires to honor her, he will not allow that to happen. But with us, we give flimsy excuses. Even when your leader asks you to come for a meeting, you won't come. It's a sign of dishonor. You are not submitted. You are just proclaiming, I submit to an authority. We still don't understand. If you submit to someone, you will obey them. Can I hear an amen in the house? There even has to be an aspect of trembling when they give you an instruction. One of the things I have come, but I think it was instilled by my father, because I really worked very closely with my father. And with him, he never took any nonsense. He tells you to do something, you say you have forgotten, he'll tell you it was not important. That's why you forgot. So that discipline made me be like this. I'm not saying I don't forget, but by the grace of God, with somebody who is in authority, they ask me to do something, I will stop everything else. It's a matter of emergency. Even my own husband, when he tells me, on your way home, buy me this and that, I stop everything and make arrangements for that thing to be brought where I am, so that by the time I'm going home, I have it. Are we together? But you see, at times, especially husband, you know, your husband is also your friend. You can be very casual with them. You know, he will understand. I'll just tell him I was tired. What will happen with time, they will begin to realize you don't take them seriously. And guess what? There are other people who tremble when they talk. Eish. Then before you know it, you start fighting with a secretary who runs very fast when your husband calls. Or even your house help. Your husband will be saying, iron my shirt. One time. Iron my shirt, babe. Two times. Babe, did you iron my shirt? Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. But if he called your house girl, hey, she will feel it's a privilege to even touch the shirt of the man of the house. And she will iron swiftly and even go and ask, is it okay, Baba Nani? You just iron for the sake of, iko sawa, hiyo hata ukivaa, kuna mtu atajua ija nini. That is not, you are not showing honor and submission. Are we together? Are we together? Yeah. So are you seeing yourselves? You may not have done the one for ironing, but I'm talking of the way we take, especially when you become close to an authority. You know, authorities are amazing. People in authority are also human beings. They have the human aspect. And like now, the authorities I have around me, can I mention them? Father, he's a very easy person and very loving. My own husband, you know him. He's not a stranger to anyone. He likes making jokes. He likes being happy. He loves people as well. My own father, Bishop Murray, he's also a very loving and easy person. So if you don't tell yourself, I am dealing with an authority, you will forget. All of them, three of them, when they are happy, they can even high five. Hey! Well, me, when I see my authority high fiving, I have told myself, stay sober. You receive, of course, you can't tell them, I will not give a high five. But you're telling yourself, this is when now you remember, this is not your peer. Are we together? Are we understanding? Because they can high five you and give you a strong instruction immediately. Then you are still there laughing. And feeling, yeah, we'll also high five even when I don't do whatever you have said. By the way, the same three people, they are also very powerful. Yeah, if you don't deliver, they will not be happy with you. Are we together? So I'm just saying that you need to understand an authority is for your good, as we learned, and can also be for your punishment, depending on how you... Mom is a submitted woman, and she has always taught us. Do you know, Mom has always taught me that I should not fight to be preaching. I am not in competition with my husband. She has said that many times from the first day I met her. And I have always remembered that. The only time I preach is when my husband tells me, now go. Because at that time, I'm operating under his grace. Are we together? As much as I went to Bible school with him, graduated together, she has always reminded me, you are not in competition with your husband. Yeah, you are a helper. She spelled that word very well to me, that you are called to be a helper. Submit to him, support his vision, pray for your husband, pray for your children. You know, the other day, Mom, I feel like crying. God. I wish, ladies, you can learn from this mother that God has given us. The other day, nowadays when we go to Kitengela, I drive with our kids. I decided to go with them so that they can always be with me. And I think it was last Sunday when we were driving, I remembered mom telling me, you know, Pastor Mercy, when my children were younger, I was always with them. We were always going together. I'm going for shopping, I'm with my children. I'm going to church, I'm with my children. And she was giving me advice. As long as they can, you know, when they grow, they want to be by themselves, isn't it? It's like she was telling me, spend more time with your children. Mentor them, teach them. You know, instill godly character. Pray for your children. And at that time, probably it never made sense. Right now, it's making sense. Because I'm seeing they are growing. Maybe when they become teenagers, they'll be telling me, no, mom, we are hanging out with our friends. Then I'll be thinking, I never spent enough time with them. So I'm doing it even more. Why? Because she gave me that counsel. Are we together? Praise the Lord. So we have to submit. By submitting, we do what? We honor them and we also obey. There is no point for any authority to teach you anything if you will not obey. Because it will just be good things you had, but they have not affected your life. Obedience, when you are relating with an authority, if you are really submitted, you have to obey them. When you come on Sunday, when you come for any teaching, listen and go, at least apply one principle. You will see progress in your life. The reason we come to church from January to December and we are still the same is because we are not applying, we are not obeying the things that we are asked to do. Simple things like pay your tithe, you know, come serve in the house of God. Show up for midweek meetings. Come on Tuesday for breakthrough service. Come on Sunday. Come on time. Come early. With an expectant heart, we won't do those things. And you claim, I'm submitted to you, ma'am. It's just a cliche. But from today, somebody say from today, we are changing in Jesus' name. We also submit to authorities by loving them. By loving them. If you submit to someone you don't love, it will be such a heavy task, okay? Because it will not be flowing from your heart. There will be a lot of pretending. And then they will also sense, because when you are in their presence, it's like you are trying to act in a certain, because it's not flowing. Let me tell you, people confuse honor and submission with fear. Those two do not correlate. Where there is fear, there is no love. And me, I don't want somebody to be claiming to submit when they fear me. It means they are not genuine. Yeah, if you submit to me as an authority, then you have to show love to me. Yeah, be yourself, be easy, don't be tensed in my presence. When I was saying that, when I see pups, I sweat. When we were from Langata, Manze Kai, Unashindwa, is he a human being? The way he walks, you feel it's like a whole presence has entered. It's like you even feel like even the atmosphere has changed. That should never leave our hearts. Mom, there's a way she walks with a lot of grace, majestic and class and style. Up to today, I was looking at her heels. I said, girl, I will be there. I don't know when I will get there because I'm still struggling with my 3-inch. But she still can balance herself. And she's my mother. That is to mean we are not. Praise the Lord. Are we together? So I'm saying that if you will submit, it has to start with love. A husband you love genuinely, you will not struggle to submit to them. A pastor you love, you will not struggle to submit to them. You cannot say you are so submitted that when you see your pastor, you run away. Like, really? My God, that is confusion. When you see your pastor, you should run to where they are. If you see them in a mall, why would you enter a shop and wait for them to pass? I think I'm dialing somebody's number. At you have seen mom carrying her handbag at Galleria or at Java. Napita hiyo njia ingine. Like, really? Ama, she was parking her car. I decided I will not leave my car as inione. Because I submit, it's a lie. That is the moment you get excited. Oh, ma'am,
You are in this mall. What? How can I be a blessing? You even tell her, you may not have come to eat, but as you do your shopping, why do we go to the malls? You just decide, you know what, it's an opportunity to be blessed. What a way to start my day today. And you decide, ma'am, make yourself happy with something. I'm not saying she does not, ma'am is blessed. What do you mean? Yes, properly, too much. And do you know we do not gift our authorities because they are in need. We gift them because that is how we plug in for blessing. Hush. Can I hear an amen in the house? Don't ever go to show up before your authority unless you don't have empty handed. Do not. By the grace of God, when I come to this house, I don't just come with my offering, the one I took at the, no. I bring a gift because I'm coming to my mother. And I cannot afford to walk out of these gates the same way I came. How do you go to visit your parents? You don't have a shopping. Ati unajua manze, wanajua kuna corona. What do you mean? But do you eat in your house? Yeah. Carry again. When you talk about authorities, you submit to them, then there has to be honor. There has to be honor, there has to be obedience, and there has to be love. Can I hear an amen in the house? So what happens to people? So what is the power of submission? The power of submission, number one, is that when you submit, you enjoy favor with authorities. You enjoy favor with authorities. The moment you learn how to relate with an authority, all of a sudden, hey, you'll become an envy of many people. In the office where you work, have you ever thought of buying a gift for your boss? Even during Christmas season? I mean, have you ever surprised even on their birthday? You know the birthday, your boss's birthday. But have you ever even thought of even doing a card for them? A thank you card for even employing you. We only gather together to complain as colleagues. And you are a Christian, you are a believer. But if you can learn to submit and honor, gift them, love them, you know, appreciate them, they will sense. Can I tell you something? Authorities know people who honor them. You may not go to them. You don't need to pendekeza yourself. They know. The anointing in them knows. The spirit in them knows. And what you realize, when they see you, they will just brighten up. And they will extend a hand of favor. Look at someone like Abigail. She was a woman. And King David was very furious with her husband. He had even planned. He was coming to massacre all the male, the men in that house. Both children and mature men. And Abigail went ahead and rode her donkey and went to meet the king. And when she saw David, she dismounted, Nato could dismount the donkey and lay down flat, started telling the king, the mistake that was done is on me, pleading for mercy. And do you know, as much as the king was furious, he just said, I have heard you, Abigail. It is the book of 1 Samuel chapter 25. I have heard you, and you know what? I'm turning back. I will not come to kill as I had purposed. And fast forward, when her husband died, the king said, that wise woman, submissive, honoring, a woman who knows how to talk to an angry king, I need her in my house. He just sent for people to go for Abigail. And when she was told, she said, hey, who doesn't mind? I don't mind being the queen. You understand? And she went and got married. But what am I saying? When you learn how to relate with authorities, you enjoy favor. The reason you don't have favor in your office is because your boss has never had you abuse them, calling them names, but their spirit knows you. Hey, nobody will have courage to go and speak against a boss on their face. It's a lie, unless you're out of your mind. But we mama in our hearts, we call them names privately when we are having coffee with our colleagues. But you don't know that wherever they are, their spirit is with you and they know you. Your pastor, you may be gossiping him in your house. Then you come on Sunday, pastor, speak a blessing. He will speak, but the one who releases the blessing knows you better. It will never come. So by actually fighting an authority, you are ruining your own life. Nikama committing suicide. Boy, there's something I want you never to forget. Eh? An authority nikama steamer. It is like electricity. Would you ever touch
Yeah. Would you ever touch a live wire with bare hands? Unless you want to die, isn't it? Can you tell your neighbor the thima? Like touching your alive wire with bare hands. That is what you do when you dishonor an authority. Hey, somebody say, ouch. Another thing that happens, I only have two more and we are done. When you submit to authorities, we say, number one, you enjoy favor. Number two, you enter into authority. By submitting to an authority, you also become someone who is in authority. Now, this scripture, Matthew 8:9, is actually a centurion, and he had come to ask for prayer from Jesus for a servant who was sick and he was back home. And he was pleading with Jesus, please pray for my servant. He's sick and whatever. And Jesus wanted to actually go and pray. And he said, no, you don't even need to come to my house. Just speak a word from where you are. My servant will be healed. For he said now, from the scripture I want to read, yes, I know this because I am a man. Can we read together? I am under the authority of my superior officers. And I have authority over my soldiers. I only need to say, go, and they go. Come, and they come. And if I say to my slaves, do this, they do it. This man was saying, because I am first under authority, then I am in authority. Do you understand the difference? Somebody say, can you tell yourself, if I can be under authority, then I will be in authority. I told us, ladies, one of the reasons you are struggling in your office, in your house, you can't tell anybody to do anything and they do, it is because you also don't receive authority from anyone. Yeah, you are actually reaping what you sow. But if you can be under authority, you will see that even as a woman, God will raise you to be somebody who is in authority. I see God raising women. After this meeting, as you begin to align and to follow and to submit to authorities, I see God raising CEOs, managers, pastors, bishops who are women. Bishops. Amma, you don't think a woman can be a bishop? It is possible. A bishop is an overseer where you even plant churches. Are we together? Wacha niwaeleze kitu. I told you, I have not always been submitted properly. You know, you can submit like 60% and act very nice. But the Lord has been dealing with me in that area of submission. You realize I'm speaking about it with a lot of passion. And the Lord told me, this man you see, called Pastor Jimmy, you have to honor him with all that you have. And you have to submit to him. Me, I listen to my husband's messages. Especially when I feel drained and tired. Kitambo, I just used to listen to music. Nowadays, I plug into his podcast. I listen. Let me tell you, I get revelation. I feel a grace to pray. I receive anointing. I become so refreshed. Because when you submit to an authority, especially your pastor, you will even love his voice. His voice becomes like melodious to your soul. Because he's the one who speaks into your life. Can I hear an amen in the house? And I'm believing God because every day when I'm going to Kitengela, he tells me, Kitengela is a mega church. I believe very soon, hey, you will hear news about Kitengela. Because he's continually speaking a blessing. And my prayer is, may I continue to be aligned. Do you know when we feel puffed up? It is when we think we are successful. So I'm praying for myself that even when we'll have 2,000 members in Kitengela, by the grace of God, because he has already prophesied. And my father bishop also added, and my husband asked him, please kindly pray for Pastor Mercy. He also prayed, anointing Mbili. From very high, what are you even talking about? Thousands are coming there. A cathedral will also come up there. But may I not forget, because the day I start feeling tunatoshana with my husband, that will be the day I start going down. Are we together? Tell your neighbor, submit to your authorities by obeying them, by loving them, and number three, by praying for them. It is a sign of submission to pray for your authority. You have no right whatsoever to question an authority, to challenge an authority, to criticize an authority. If you feel by any chance that something is out of order, or because no human being is perfect, isn't it? The best place you can take is a place of prayer. From a place of submission, not accusing them before God. God, deal with my husband. Deal with him. Deal. My friend, those kind of prayers, I don't think they will go anywhere. But when you tell the Lord, Lord, you brought me as a helper, and I would really want to help my husband. Lord, kuna hii area naona, things are not really going well. Lord, please, would you please help your son? From a place of humility, that prayer will be answered. But if you are telling God, punish him so that he can know I am his wife, he has wronged me. So it's like you really would have wanted to fight back, but now that you can't, you are telling God, do it for me, Lord. He will not answer that prayer, unfortunately. Yeah, because the command of God is that we pray for those in. Can I read you the last scripture so that we can finish? The Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 and 2, therefore I exhort first of all that supplications, prayer, and intercessions and giving of thanks be made for all men, for kings and for those in authority. I'm reading from New King James Version, that we may lead a quiet and peaceful life in all godliness and reverence. So another way, I know I've taken a step back. Have you realized? Yes. Another way of honoring authorities is praying for them. I think I would have forgotten to tell you that. Yeah, pray for your authorities. Because when they do well, you also do well. Instead of criticizing and questioning every decision, pray for them. You'll be better that way and all will be well with you. So we have said the power of submission is that what you get out of submission is that you get favor, and you also walk in authority. Somebody say, I will walk in authority. Now, the last one on the results of submission is that submission leads to an inheritance. Submission leads to an inheritance. Now, one of the people who received an inheritance in the Bible by serving and being submitted is Elisha. Somebody say, Prophet Elisha. He was submitted to his leader, Elijah. And there were even other sons of prophets who were telling him, don't you know that your master will be taken away from you? Why are you following? And he said, I know, and I will keep on following. And one time Elijah asked him, what do you want from me? What can I do for you before I am taken up? And he told him, I need a double portion of your grace, of your anointing. And Elijah told him, you have asked for a very difficult thing, but if you can see me when I'm taken up, you will receive that double portion. Now, people who submit not for a season, but those who submit to the end. Somebody say to the end. Through all seasons, whether favorable or not, they are the ones who receive an inheritance. Now, can I tell you something? Something I was taught by a certain bishop. He was just sharing something and I caught that. I kept it in my heart. It is not everybody who can give you an inheritance. Inheritance is given by your father. Can I hear an amen in the house? So when you understand that, then you guard your relationship with your father, your authorities, because you know they are the only ones who can give you an inheritance. Can I hear an amen in the house? Why don't you rise up to your feet? I want us to take a place of prayer and tell God to forgive us, because I know as I was speaking, you must have seen there are some areas you need to change. It could be in the area of not being obedient, not honoring, you know, not loving, not praying for your authorities. Why don't you open your mouth and begin to tell the Lord, I know there is an area, there is that place that you know, this is what God was telling me today. Just respond in prayer. Tell the Lord, help me. If you don't help me, I cannot submit by my own power. Why don't you just open your mouth and tell the Lord, help me, guide me, help me, oh God. I receive the grace. I receive the grace to submit. I receive the grace to honor. I receive the grace to pray for my authorities. I receive the grace to obey without questioning. I receive the grace to do what I have been asked to do. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, open your mouth and begin to pray. Pray for your heart. I say the submission is an issue of the heart. If there is any element of rebellion, any element of stubbornness, any aspect of being stubborn in our hearts, in the name of Jesus, dishonor that we have to towards authorities, may God forgive us. Why don't you just pray for your heart? Pray that from today you shall honor, you shall submit to your
husband. You shall submit to your boss. You shall submit to your pastor. You shall submit to your leaders at whatever capacity. Come on, open your mouth. You will not challenge their authority. You will not criticize them. You will not gossip them. You will not entertain anybody gossiping them with you. You will not, in the name of Jesus, you will reverence them. You will look at them as people who are highly esteemed by God. You will see that when I submit, I'm submitting to God. And today we are receiving that grace. We are receiving that grace. We are receiving that grace. Why don't you declare that as I honor, I receive favor. I receive the grace to be in authority. I receive my inheritance. I receive my blessing. I shall not go through punishment for lack of submission. In the name of Jesus, I pray for my heart, oh God, that you help us. Help us, oh God, to walk in submission. Why don't you lift up your right hand? If you're telling God that I want to walk in submission, I want to obey my authorities, I want to love them, I want to honor them, I want to even appreciate them, I want to learn from them, I want to draw grace from them, I want to draw wisdom from them, I want to receive an inheritance from my authorities, I don't want to be somebody who cannot submit. Why don't you tell the Lord, please help me, I know I cannot do it by my own power. Let my perception of my authorities change. Let it be positive. Let it be that I do honor them. I don't see anything to criticize. I don't see anything to actually gossip about, in the name of Jesus. Why don't you just open your mouth and know the grace is coming upon you. The grace to submit, the grace to obey, the grace to honor. You will pray instead of criticizing. Oh, even leaders in government, instead of criticizing them, you will pray for them. You will pray for your boss instead of criticizing. Oh, you will pray for your husband instead of criticizing him. You will teach your children to pray for their father in the name of Jesus. Oh, which song can we do?
Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul.
Come on, lift up your hands and tell the Lord, it's only God who can sort out your heart.
For you,
any rebellion and Lord, stubbornness, we come against it today. In the name of Jesus. Come on, lift up your hands.
The moment I'm away, have your way.
Unless you help us, we cannot do this, oh God. For in our fallen nature, we are stubborn. We are naturally rebellious. We are naturally criticizing authorities. But Lord, today we submit our hearts to you. We yield our lives to you. We pray the Lord, you release a grace in our hearts to submit, to honor, to obey, to love those who are in authority over us, to relate well with them, to look up to them, and even to pray for them. And Father, we know that as we do this, every power that comes by submission will be our portion. We thank you because we shall walk in favor. We shall enjoy an inheritance. And we shall also be able, oh God, even to walk in authority. Father, we bless you and we honor you. We receive that grace in Jesus' mighty name. And somebody say,
amen.
If you believe that you are receiving a grace to submit, why don't you appreciate the Lord? Appreciate Jesus with a clap, with a shout. Amen. And amen. And amen. 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 So at this time, I want you to go into your pocket because there is a grace right now flowing from this altar. I also need my wallet. I want us to get a very nice offering. Go into your wallet, go into your phone and give the very best. I want us to give an offering to connect, to tap into a grace of submission. Our mother is submitted, I say that. Our mother is she's an amazing example of what it means to submit. I am also believing God for the same grace to flow in me. So we want to sow a seed on this altar and declare from today, we will walk in submission. And by that, every blessing that comes by submission will be our portion in Jesus' name. When you come, declare, I receive favor. I receive authority. I receive my blessing, my inheritance in Jesus' name. If you have your offering, I want to pray for it. Amen. If you're giving through your phone, please, we have the details on your screen. We want to just make sure you package a very nice offering and may God honor you as you do that. Lift it up. If you are using your phone, lift your phone up. That grace is coming upon your life. You are just sowing a seed into the grace to submit in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you as we honor you with our offerings today. We declare that we have already opened our hearts and we even place a seed on the altar, declaring that from today we are done with stubbornness. We are done with rebellion. We receive the grace to submit. We will flow with our authorities. We will love them. We will pray for them. We will honor them in the name of Jesus. And we receive that grace today in Jesus' mighty name we pray. And somebody said, amen. Give us a very nice song that we can dance, because this one we need to dance. Yeah? When we think of the favor that is coming, the authority to be also in authority after you are under authority, and the inheritance you are about to receive, you cannot come when you are, you come when you are dancing in Jesus' name. Amen. Angel, which one are we doing?
Are you ready to rejoice? Please give me some power. Oh,
amen.
Hey, are you ready to rejoice in the presence of the Lord? He's worthy. Hey, I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna dance and praise Him.
Come as you're dancing
and bring your offering. It doesn't matter what comes my way.
Is coming
the greater one lives inside. His name is Jesus.
To give the Lord a praise. Let's put our hands together for mom as she comes Amen. And as she comes, I would like you to know, when you submit, even the battles you're going through, the Lord will fight for
Amen.
You. When you are in a place of submission, submit, because there is power in submission. Amen.
Can I sanitize? I want to sanitize. Let me sanitize for you.
Ladies, that was a great word.
Yes.
It was a real great word. It was a great word. Submission is a grace from God.
Yes.
And whatever you need, ladies, whatever you need, obtain that grace of submission from God. You need to obtain that grace of submission from God, continually to use it to work and to walk. You need to walk in submission as you live here, ladies. Continue to walk in submission as you live here. Please continue to walk in submission. Are you going to walk in submission?
Yes.
You need to walk in submission. You need to, ladies. You need to. And as you live here, continue to walk in submission. You heard that word. It was a great word. It was a great word from God. It was a great word from God. It really was a great word. Let's appreciate Pastor Masiya for that. And now as you leave here, may the Lord bless you in your going out and in your coming in, whenever. Will, as you continue to come in to the house of God, to be in His presence. God bless you. See you at our next King's Daughters meeting, 4th of September. Come again in the presence of God. Come again in the presence of God, and God will bless you every time you come into the house of God to be in His presence. God, you just don't come to meet people. You come to be in the presence of God. And also, see you tomorrow at our service, 10 a.m. God bless you. God bless you in your going out. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, ladies. See you again on 4th of September. Continue to walk in submission.
Rejoice in Him. I rejoice in more than a conqueror. Still more than a conqueror. I am more than a conqueror. More than